Welcome back to Household Labs. I'd like to show you my forge and some of the projects I've been using it for. So here's the main body of the forge. It has a brake drum on top, connected with a pipe to a T that leads to the air intake and to this aluminum can on the bottom that catches any water or ashes that fall down into the pipes. Inside the drum, there's a pipe cap with 8 holes drilled in it, which allows the air to flow into the drum. I've built a simple concrete stand out of blocks that the forge sits nicely into. A flexible aluminum pipe fits onto the end of the air intake, and also a hair dryer on the other end supplies the air for the forge. I first start the forge with small pieces of sticks and wood. Once the fire is hot enough for some larger sticks and a nice bed of coals has been laid, I turn on the hair dryer to give the fire more oxygen. As you can see, the fire starts roaring from all of the extra air and it gets a lot hotter. Then I added a little bit of coal to the fire and put some lead from a car battery in a steel can on the fire, which immediately started releasing poisonous lead gases. It only took about 30 seconds to melt the lead completely, and it stopped producing the gas. I poured it into this pan, and you can see that it is completely melted. Next, I put a block of aluminum in the can, which smelt at a higher temperature than lead. I added more coal to make sure that it would melt. And in just a few minutes, the entire block was molten and ready to pour. After the aluminum, I tried to melt these brass bullet casings, which should take a lot more heat than the aluminum. Unfortunately, my thin steel crucible melted through before the brass melted, and all the casings fell out into the fire. The next morning, when I was emptying the unburnt coal and ashes out of the fire, I found this piece of coal which had brass melted into it. You can see the rose gold and yellow pieces that are actually melted brass embedded in the coal. After I was done melting metals, I decided to start forging some steel. This is a railroad spike that I found near my house. It heated up very quickly, so I began trying to make a knife out of it. This front section you see will be the blade. I also heated the back of the railroad spike to shape the handle of the knife. With this simple forge design and some coal, I was able to heat steel enough to blacksmith and melt and cast aluminum. Well, thanks for watching Household Labs, and I hope you learned something new.